Welcome to day five of competition here at the 2017 Summer Universiade in Taipei. We will head over to the Taiwan Sport University Arena to recap yesterday's seven swimming finals. We'll start with the women's 1500 meter freestyle race. Italy's Simona Quattarella had a tough start to the race, falling behind quickly. You can see her in lane four now, just catching up after the first length. It was Germany's Kohler who led the way, followed closely by USA's Moore. No one would go for a world record here. Germany's Kohler still in the lead. Quattarella, though, passes Moore on that second length. But this is where Quattarella really kicks it into high gear. She leads the way going into this final length. Coming to the end now with a big lead, it's Italy's Quattarella that takes the gold medal with a time of 15 minutes, 57.9 seconds, setting a new Universiade record for this event. Germany's Sarah Kohler comes in second, and it's the USA's Hannah Moore who earns the bronze. Next up was the women's 200-meter individual medley. Now there's something about that lane four, so keep an eye on it. This time it's Japan's Yu Ohashi who occupies that lane, and she's going to go for the gold as well. But it's her teammate Miho Teramira who leads after the first length with a time of 29.06 seconds, followed by Canadian Sarah Darcel and Korea's Seong Kim. After the second, it's Kim that takes the lead, but Ohashi is quickly catching up to the leader. Heading into the final length of this 200-meter race, it's Ohashi who comes out on top. You can see her leading the pack in lane four. She ends in first place, setting another Universiade record with a time of 2 minutes, 10.03 seconds. Next was the men's 200-meter breaststroke. And it was the USA's Andrew Wilson that led the entire time. After the first length, he swam in 29.03 seconds. He didn't give up the lead until the very end of the 200 meters. You can see him in lane two. He's leading the way after the first, followed by the Russian athlete and the Swiss athlete not far behind. Approaching the end here, it's clear that the USA athlete in lane two wins the gold with a time of 2 minutes, 8.45 seconds. It was Dmitry Balandin of Kazakhstan who came in second with a time of 2 minutes, 9.7 seconds, and the Russian athlete, Rustam Gadarov, who finished in third with a time of 2 minutes, 9.72 seconds. Next was the women's 100-meter backstroke. This is a quick race, just there and back. After the first length, it was the USA's Hannah Stevens that led the way with a time of 28.92 seconds. But Australia's Sean Whitaker came back quickly to take the gold. You can see here both American athletes leading the way as Sean Whitaker in lane five. Kicks it into high gear at the end of this race for a last minute push to take the gold medal with a time of 1 minute 0.14 seconds. The USA's Hannah Stevens wins the silver, and it's Japan's Anna Konishi who earns the bronze. Next was the men's 200-meter butterfly final. This race was dominated by the Japanese athletes. Both Daya Seto and Nayo Horomura medaled in this event, coming in almost 2 seconds faster than the third-placed athlete. Seto led the way after the first length, Alexander Kudashev in second, and Horomura in third. Almost a minute into this race, it was Japan's Horomura who would step it up into high gear, taking the lead at the 100-meter mark and not giving it up for the rest of the race. You can see him in lane three. Touches the wall, gets back, still leading the way. It's Seto right behind him and Kudashev in third. Horimura in the third lane. He touches the wall first, earns that gold medal in the 200-meter butterfly race, also setting another Universiad record with a time of 1 minute 53.90 seconds. Next, the eight athletes competing in the men's 50-meter backstroke took to the pool. It was Ireland's Shane Ryan that came out on top of this short race, but only by a sliver over the USA's Justin Ress. You can see them in lane two and lane six. To the naked eye, it looks like they almost touch at the exact same time. Two and six, look at that. And with a time of 24.72 seconds, it was Ireland's Shane Ryan that took the gold medal. USA's Justin Ress, time of 24.73 seconds, takes the silver, and it's Korea's Jung Jung Won who took the third. Next up was the women's 4x200-meter freestyle relay. It was teams from Russia, the United States of America, Japan, the United Kingdom of Great Britain, Canada, Italy, Australia, and Brazil that would compete for the medal. Canada led the way after the first lap. Russia fought back. They took the lead now heading into the second. Just under a minute left to go. It was Great Britain in first and Canada falling behind once again in that second spot. But USA's Catherine Drabot got them the lead back right in front of Russia, followed closely behind by Brazil. USA keeps that lead, followed by Russia as they head into their final lap. It's USA now in the lead in the last length. In lane three and four, it was Russia and the United States of America that would go head-to-head in this final 50 meters of the 200-meter race. USA's Ella Easton and Russia's Arina Openishiva would end the race at 1 and 2, Russia pulling ahead by just 0.04 seconds. Russia takes it with a time of 7 minutes, 55.28 seconds. The USA in silver and Japan takes the bronze. The finals of both the men's and women's team fencing events took place today at the Nanjing Exhibition Center. It was the women's gold medal match between the Ukraine and the USA that was up first. The USA was represented by Barbara Van Bethzuen, Catherine Holmes, Anna Van Bruin, and Catherine Nixon. The Ukraine, represented by Yulia Svetso, Ksenia Ieva, Zone Bezhura, and Anafisa Pokalova. The first bout of nine would take place between Bezhura and Van Bruin, and it was the Ukraine's Bezhura that took it 5-1 after the first bout. Next up was the Ukraine's Svetso and the USA's Holmes. They went at it, scoring two touches apiece. So at the end of their bout, it was 7-3 in favor of the Ukraine. And then in the fourth, it was Van Bruin and the Ukraine Svetso that matched up. This one would be finally won by the USA as Van Bruin took it 5-3, ending the bout 16-15, taking the first lead for the USA. Holmes would drop the next bout 5-8 to the Ukraine. It gets tied right back up 29 apiece, but the Ukraine steps ahead once again thanks to Pokalova. Then it was Bezhura and Holmes going at it. Holmes would score 15 touches in the second last round, but Bezhura would go on to score 11 touches in that round, tying it up 44-44. You can watch in the final seconds, Catherine Holmes on the offensive ties it up, and now these two athletes will go into overtime. In the overtime, Holmes goes on the attack once again, but it's Bezhura who is able to put the point on the board, and she wins it. Team Ukraine will take the gold medal 45-44 over Team USA. This is a special victory for the 25-year-old after a 28th place finish in the individual event on August 20th. She previously won a silver medal at the 2016 World Cup and a bronze medal at the 2017 World Cup. Adding this gold at a Universiade is a perfect way to end her competition here at the 2017 Summer Universiade. Next was the men's saber team final here at the Nanyang Exhibition Center. This one took place between Korea and Iran. Korea was represented by Kim Jun-ho, Gu Bong-gil, Oh Sang-guk, and Jang Ti-hoon. On the other side, Iran was represented by Farzad Erasbaran, Ali Pakdaman, Mohammed Razbari, and Mohammed Fotahi. In this first bout between Sang-guk and Razbari, it got close as Razbari took the first lead, but Sang-guk able to tie it up. At the end of this first bout, though, it was Iran that led 5-4. We'll fast forward now to the fifth of nine bout. This one was between Oh and Fotoe. Each athlete here would score 5 touches each. That brings it to a total of Iran 21 and Korea 25. Then in the sixth, it was Korea's Gu that went on the offensive, scoring another 5 touches and bringing the score even higher. This one ended with a score of Korea 30 and Iran 26. Iran wasn't able to get any touches in the eighth bout, so in the final bout, it was Oh that took the offensive. He was up 45-30 at the end of it, and he won the gold medal for Team Korea over Team Iran. The 20-year-old athlete from Beijing University finished 24th in the individual men's saber, now helping his team win a gold in the team event. BSU President Oleg Matitsyn presented the team with the gold medals. Now, the Republic of Korea is in first place in the medal table so far at the university with the help of the men's saber fencing team. With this victory, they bring their country's total to 47 medals, including 19 golds. We'll move over to the Taiwan University Sports Center now between the preliminary round matchup between Team Brazil and Team Russia. Now, Brazil lost to Finland early in the tournament, but they came back and beat Mexico in a 3-0 game. It was Russia that beat Mexico. They also beat Finland, so they are going undefeated so far in this one. A spike by Russia's Natalia Krotkova gets Brazil on the board first. They take the first lead of the game. Russia battles back, though, and a spike by Natil Goncalves of Brazil is out, and Russia takes back the lead in the first at the set point. It's Brazil's Goncalves at it again with the spike. Looks like it's out, but the ref is going to say it is tipped out by Russia, and that gives Brazil 1-0. That is Russia's first game loss. They've won every other game 3-0 in the preliminary round. Moving on to the second. It was Brazil's Dalia Prado. Big block and another big dig by Stephanie Carrera to keep it alive for Russia. Now it's Brazil's setter. A little dump there. Russia able to keep it alive. A massive hit, but an even bigger block by Brazil's number 3, Natalia Krotkova. At set point now for Russia, looking to take it. And they made a statement in this game, taking it by the biggest lead of 25-15. Now Russia leads 2-1 with Brazil. A nice poke from Sidjo from Brazil gets them back into the game. They take the lead 4-2 early on. But Russia, of course, they battle back. Brazil keeps the lead, however, and a huge dig here followed by a massive spike by Fernanda Tomé to slam down the lead at 17-13. But Russia would battle back. They're leading now 20-19. This would be the longest rally that we see all day. Spikes, blocks, and just keeping it alive for both teams. Russia able to get it right back over the net. Brazil sets up a spike. Tipped up. Russia again, just keeping it alive. Another big block by Russia. Able to get it again. Tomé tries for the spike, but it lands inbounds. No one there to cover. Russia takes the lead now 21-19 at the set point. Goncalves tries to get the slam down. It's blocked. Brazil keeps it alive, but gives Russia another chance, and you can't give them another chance. A huge monster slam by Pankova to win the match. Russia takes it 3-1 over Brazil. Russia now undefeated in this preliminary round. Both teams will head to playoffs tomorrow. After an hour-long rain delay, the athletics event began yesterday at Taipei Stadium, and the day ended with the finals of both the men's shot put and the women's 10,000-meter race. Daria Maslova began this race as a favorite. The athlete from Kyrgyzstan competed at the 2016 Olympic Games and had the lead most of this Universiad race. It was Japan's Yuki Munehisa who took the early lead. You'll be able to see her on the outside shortly in the red. Once the race got going, she continued in that lead, followed closely behind by Maslova in second. At the 9,000-meter point, it was Maslova still in second, but at the 33 mark, the final lap, Maslova finally kicks it into high gear, followed closely by India's Sanjeevani Jadhav. But it wouldn't be close for long. Maslova sprinting this last 100 meters at her first Universiad here in Taipei. She will take the gold medal for the 10,000-meter race. She finishes with a time of 33 minutes, 19.27 seconds. It was India's Jadhav that won the silver with a time of 33 minutes and 22 seconds, a personal best for the Indian athlete. Japan's Hosoda Ai came in third. Kyrgyzstan now sits at 7 medals after Maslova went on to win the women's 5,000-meter race as well. Then it was time for the men's shot put finals. 12 athletes qualified for the final of this event. We will watch Romania's Andrei Gheg go up first. In his first throw, he reached 19.68, but this second one would be his best yet. You see how happy he is with that one. That's because it was 20.12. It would be good enough for the bronze medal. Moving on now to Poland's Konrad Bukowski. In his fourth attempt, he reached 20.16. Doesn't look too happy, but he'll be happy when he knows it's good enough for the silver. Now, Portugal's Francisco Bello. In his first throw, he reached 19.24, but it was his third throw that would win the gold. As he watches it goes, he knows it is good. This one reaches a length of 20.86. Watch again his release at the perfect point. He watches it goes, instinctively knows that one is good. That's a personal best for him at 20.86. That's good enough for the gold medal. Bello did compete in the 2017 World Championships, didn't qualify for the final, but was able to redeem himself here with the number one spot in shot put. He will also compete in the discus on August 26th.
Ladies and
it was now time to head to the Fujiang Catholic University Stadium in New Taipei City for the football match between the men's team of Italy and Brazil. The winner of this game would go on to play Japan tomorrow in the quarterfinals. So let's get this one underway. It was Brazil that would get the first shot on net just off the post. It was Italy able to keep it out and get that ball on the other side of the field. You can see Brazil worrying a little bit there. But on the other end, it was a nice pass here by Italy's Riccardo Chiarello. Right up to Tommaso Mastrelli for the goal number one for his team. Right now, it's Italy leading the way. Check out the pass again, right through the defender's legs. Able to sink it in the top corner over the goalie. No one saw that one coming. Watch from this angle. Right past the defense of Daniel De Paulo Oliveira of Brazil. On the other end, it's Brazil. Tries to keep it alive and tie the game. A nice kick from the outside, but it's too strong. Out of bounds, it goes back to Italy. Now in extra time, Brazil's goalkeeper Ferreira comes out, leaves the net to try and poke the ball away. He gets it, but it's picked up now by Vittorio Favo. He kicks it in. The long bomb from the crease is good now to give Italy the 2-0 lead. You can see as the goalkeeper just cannot get back. He's faked out to the right. And with less than a minute left to go, Italy has that 2-0 lead over Brazil. As the time clicks on, they know they have it. Italy takes it and they will now advance to the quarterfinals tomorrow versus Japan. Brazil will also play tomorrow in a consolation match against Malaysia. Time now for some archery action at the National Taiwan Sport University Archery Field. The men's and women's recurve team finals took place today. First up is the men's bronze medal match between Russia and Kazakhstan.
Target number one, the team from Kazakhstan.
In the first set, Russia was able to pull ahead and put two quick nines up on the board. Kazakhstan came back though and eventually took the lead in the third set after being down 4-0 to Team Russia. In the third set, Kazakhstan continues to build on their lead over Russia, but is it too little too late? 54-45 in the third, but with a 9 to win it, Russia earns the bronze medal with a score of 5-1 over Team Kazakhstan.
Team Recurve Men's Team Universiade Team.
Now the gold medal match between the Republic of Korea and Team Taipei. In the first set, it stayed close until midway through when Korea began to pull ahead. They would eventually end that one with a score of 58-45.
Korea, two set points for Team Korea.
Then with Korea up 4-0, Taipei started off hot with a lead of 46-28. But Korea came back late with back-to-back 10-pointers. You can see there, 47, then moved to 57, and they win the gold medal with a total score of 6-0 over the Chinese Taipei.
Medalist, the team from Korea.
The women's finals got underway as well with the bronze medal match between Italy and Russia. Russia got on the board first with an 8-pointer, followed up by another one and another one. But Italy answered back with a 7, a 10, and another 7, ending up losing that first set. Fast forward now to the third set, Italy in the lead, and Russia looked to battle back to earn a spot on the podium. With two twos and a big 10, they end and win the bronze over Italy by a score of 6-0. And then it was Team Taipei taking on Team Korea in the women's gold medal match. In the first set, Korea started off hot, ending with a score of 27, but Taipei had a bit more fire, scoring 29 and winning the first. Now Taipei up 2-0 over Korea, but Korea would bounce back, winning the second and third sets decisively. By the time the fourth came around, this gold medal match could have gone either way. Korea down 10, 59-49. They would need a 10 to win the game, can't get it, so Taipei ties it up. Now in the tiebreak, Korea takes the lead 22-9, and a 10-pointer by Korea ices the game, and they win the gold medal with a score of 5-4 over the host city's team. This ends the archery competition at the Universiade. Korea earned 8 medals in this sport, including 6 golds.